ain't seen nothing yet. Watch this.
They're innocent bystanders who are lured into conspiracies by people like Caleb or like friend Mike Oxbig, aka Robot Polisher.
Robot Polisher,
my guy.
Robot Polisher is the dude who put together that montage of me waking up to shit. It was the seven stages of Flat Earth Awakening when I was like bargaining and angry and drunk, and it was fucking genius.
He is one of the leading voices telling people about the truth.
See, my boy, it's nature's way. Upon the weak, the strong ones prey. In human life, it's also true. The strong will try to conquer you. Ooh. And that is what you must expect. Unless you use your intellect.
And I mean, you know, imagine polishing a robot for 13 hours. Jesus. Right?
I think
that's a lot of polishing.
It was Klaus Schwab who said that, right? I think it's Klaus Schwab from the WEF guy. Okay, not everyone can be a robot polisher. Yeah, that's Klaus Schwab said that. I think he's talking about the future of automation of jobs and things like that is what I would imagine.
In other words, there's too many humans because once the world is run by unthinking machines, not everybody can just polish robots all day. We'll have to come up with something else for them to do. Maybe they'll just die.
I mean, I think it's a funny quote.
You'll have to use your brain for a change.
And it's a funny thing for Klaus Schwab to say. Not everyone can be a robot polisher.
Everybody can be a robot polisher.
Not everyone can be a robot polisher.
Not everyone can be a robot polisher.
It's hilarious. So I'll give it that.
It's a great quote.
Not everybody can be a robot polisher.
You know why? You know why Flat Earth is so big? Because everyone has the same story. No one ever goes, yeah, the Earth is flat. Oh, cool. I believe that. Everyone says, shut the fuck up.
I've come to the conclusion that I don't think we have a knowledge issue. I think we have a wisdom issue. Because the truth is out there, and those who seek it find it.
Dude, you guys just haven't looked into it. That's
no,
all it is.
You're watching
you guys
YouTube videos,
into it.
Eddie. There's a difference between looking into it and watching YouTube videos.
Just haven't looked into it. That's all.
Eddie.
I used to say the same
Eddie,
stuff.
Eddie, you're talking about the earth being
this,
flat. Thousands
I'm
of scientists have looked into it. You think they're all wrong? That's so insane.
You haven't looked into it.
His website's dedicated to debunking it.
Everyone has the same story. When I first heard about Flat Earth, I thought it was the dumbest shit ever. I thought it was a CIA psyop. It must be some kind of distraction.
Pure psyop brought to you by the intelligence agencies.
The Earth isn't flat. That's fucking insane.
About all these satellites they're claiming that are going up to space. Where are the waves going from your cell phone?
I was violently opposed to it. I was mad at people that would bring it up.
There's no fucking way the Earth is flat.
A friend of mine was posting all these things on Facebook. It was pissing me off. You know, I was like, what the fuck? Is he fucking with me?
God, this is a fucking nightmare. I can't be a flat earth person.
Exact same story. Everybody. No one just believes it right away.
Ask and you shall receive. Seek and you shall find. Knock and it shall be opened unto you.
Look for the truth. Okay. Look into it like you're investigating. Just look into both sides. There's a reason why it's becoming huge. There's a reason. Have you watched History of Flat Earth by Eric Dubin? Have you seen that?
Sure have.
How long is it?
I don't have an hour for that.
Those who seek the truth inevitably find it.
The only problem with the flat earth rabbit hole, whatever you want to call it, is it's kind of hard to beat.
God damn it. The Earth is clearly not a fucking spinning ball.
Started going into the research and boom.
Oh, fucking stupid.
Unbelievable. Like,
how the fuck are we supposed to handle all of this?
There's nothing compares. Nothing compares to the whole quote-unquote flat earth research rabbit hole.
It's all just a con. It's all just a... like a play they're putting on.
And everyone believes it.
Maybe really this is lost knowledge. Maybe it truly is lost knowledge. What humans are, what our planet is, and what this is all about.
There's nothing more mind-blowing than realizing that we've been lied to the point where we don't even know where we are. I can't think of any other experience topping that.
This can't be reality.
Even like the so-called smartest people in the world we'll all be like, these flat earthers are retarded, you know?
You know, no one with a brain believes anything about the flat earth. It's absurd.
It's just ridiculous. It's absolutely, they know nothing about science. And I don't want to get mad at them. It's just that it's ridiculous.
Plus, flat earthers know that once a person says that, they're basically just admitting that they either haven't even bothered to look, or they're not smart enough to understand that the math doesn't add up. One of the two things.
We should A, seek the truth, and once we arrive at it, we should actually adopt it. So many of us reject all of the evidence.
And that's normal. Everybody that's into flat earth, It was very hard for them to get into it and admit it.
I don't know, I'm a free agent, you know? I'm kind of open-minded on the deal. I really just have questions, don't I? That's all I have. I've been lied to so much by my government, by the education system. I don't trust any of it. I don't trust any of it, quite frankly.
I don't know. Other people tell me space is fake and gay, so I guess we'll have to get to the bottom of that.
It's all fake and gay.
It's the truth. And it sets you free.
I've never seen a former flat earther. Nobody's ever seen what the actual shape of the earth is and then been like, you know what? Neil deGrasse Tyson really does give me a good argument because it's literally ridiculous.
Is the problem that people are being lied to, or is the problem that people are refusing to hear and believe the truth?
History of flat earth, look into it.
No, definitely not.
I can't, sir. Look into just it. Can't.
I hear you, sir.
Fourth grade, my teacher. Cool.
Hey, you know what? You don't care, and that's fine. I'm not going to be mad at you for not caring.
No, of course
don't
not.
Don't be mad at me for caring, though.
It is about seeking the truth and also having the wisdom to acknowledge it.
I would rather be thought as a moron for not trusting criminals than a fucking sellout and a traitor for defending them.
Not everybody can be a robot polisher.
Isn't the first stage of grief denial?
Right.
I think that so much of our population is psychologically incapable of acknowledging the fact that everything is so screwed up.
Just because you can't understand something, it doesn't mean it's wrong.
They're experiencing the pain of whatever trauma has happened. They just are denying that it exists. Like a really unhealthy psychological denial trauma stage.
Yeah.
And they just haven't gone through maybe we just need to figure out how to get them through the stages of grief.
It's a rough game. Anyone knows.
For the strong preyed upon the weak.
There are no rules. Anything goes.
Or like abuse, because I think the same thing happens with abuse, where like people who are in abusive relationships refuse to acknowledge it for a while. I mean, I guess it's the same with a lot of stuff. It's the same with like alcoholism, right? That's the first step of the 12-step program, is admitting you have a problem. So it's like you have to get over the coping, whatever coping mechanism you have that allows you to ignore the problem, because the problem doesn't just go away because you ignore it. And it's just this basic human psychology that they then inflict on the world, and it turns out it works just as well with a population as it does with an individual.
It's a battle of wits.
Yeah, absolutely. And it reminds me of Animal Farm, how the rules just slowly changed over time.
Right, right, piece by piece, yeah.
So it's like, at what point do you realize that something's terribly wrong?
The establishment wants a semi-lobotomized, quasi-retarded population.
The world is merely a tiny speck in the universe.
Universe? The world is round?
Yes, that's right. And it also goes around.
They don't want you thinking for yourself. They don't want you researching for yourself. They don't want you to be resourceful. They want you to take whatever it is they regurgitate to you, accept it as truth, and then move on, paint your body, and go to your favorite football team game.
If the boy goes about saying the world is round, he'll be so mixed up, he'll be wearing his shoes on his head.
Meanwhile, you're having everything stolen from you in the past, present, and future. But you're a semi-lobotomized, quasi-retarded member of the population, so you don't even know what's going on. You're essentially a dodo bird getting eaten up for sport.
Dude, if you haven't checked out Robot Polisher and his videos, man, this dude is like the top of the game. Please check out his material, because he's helped wake a lot of people up, man, and his videos are legit.
Fucking take over this bitch, man. Because there's an opening right now. The doggies have been let off their leash for a little bit. And so now's the time to really get out some stuff. You can feel the snake is relaxed a little bit. Fucking bang, move, get more ground. Take back ground.
You are living between two planes now, somewhere between the ceiling and the floor.